Slick Rick the Ruler. Slick Rick has been crowned the master of storytelling and the world's greatest storyteller, and rightfully so. But I'd like to go a couple steps further and talk about the vocal genius of Slick Rick the Ruler. Now, it's not my intention to insult the intelligence of anybody in the audience, but there is a difference between lyrics and vocals. But that's not something that many people take into account when discussing great MCs. Lyrics are simply words, just the words that comprise the piece of poetry, the rhyme, whatever piece of literature is in question. Well, vocals are actually the voice, the quality of the voice, the tone of the voice. And throughout the history of this rap thing, there have been many MCs who technical people like engineers and studio people, they call a certain vocal quality cutting to tape. They used to call it that back in the tape days, and we still use that particular phrase. When you say somebody's vocals just cut to tape, what that actually means is that the person in question, their vocal performance does not require the assistance of the electronics and different things in the studio to bring out certain dynamics in the voice. The voice is already dynamic on its own, and it doesn't need much more. So throughout the history of the rap game, we've always had MCs with dynamic voices. Now, it's one thing to have incredible rhymes, but not many MCs have incredible rhymes and incredible voices that cut the tape. They're going all the way back to the beginning. A lot of times the big guys, the fat guys, had those voices that just cut right through. Thinking like to the first records, Big Bang Hank, who has some negative history with him, rest in peace. But his voice always stood out on those early recordings. Kool Rock Ski from the Fat Boys. The first time I ever heard Biggie, I always knew Biggie was special. I think it was on maybe the Mary J. Blige, one of her remixes, or even maybe a Supercat song. Whatever it was, when I first heard him, he had one of those voices that just cut the tape. It was a vocal performance that just, an incredible voice. Chuck D has it. Flavor Flav, who is not really an MC, but one of the most sampled voices in hip-hop. If you go back to the 90s, everybody was sampling and scratching, you know, when he would say, yeah, boy, or, you know, that's right, y'all, whatever he would say. His vocals just cut right through. Of course, James Brown, dynamic voice. Anything he said was something that was worth sampling or putting up under your beat because the vocals were like that. Nas is another one who, you know, always incredible lyrics, but just vocally. You know, you can listen to an acapella by Nas, and it's just something about his vocal tone. He just has a great voice. And so it is with Slick Rick for several reasons. First of all, Slick Rick is from Britain, so automatically he has an accent that gives his voice a certain quality that's an advantage. It definitely works well for him. But one thing that's barely ever talked about is what he does with his voice. There's a couple techniques that Slick Rick employs that gives him a great advantage over other MCs. And I truly believe if after Slick Rick's legal troubles, if he had continued to have good production like he had on his debut album, The Great Adventures of Slick Rick, he would have stayed in the game and been relevant a lot longer. I think his production hurt him on his last couple albums, but his voice and his lyrics never faltered. Now, vocally, what Slick Rick would do, as he was telling a story, like, you got great storytellers all throughout the history of this game. You got Kool G Rap, probably one of the best, you know, as far as drawing a picture, creating a picture that you can see vividly. Kool G Rap, Biggie, you know, two of the greatest storytellers as far as just really being able to paint a mental picture where you can see. Nas. Nas had a rhyme. Nas doesn't tell that many stories, but he had a rhyme, I think it was on One Love, and it may have been the last verse when he was saying, nobody's out for shorty, doo-wop, rolling two fillies together in the bridge, we call them oo-ops. And he tells a whole story of how he sat there and smoked a blunt with this kid. And it was such a vivid story. The rhyme was dope, but the story was so vivid. You could see them on the benches in the projects in your mind. You could just picture it. So you always had great storytelling MCs. But the difference, and I don't see anybody else who really does it like Slick Rick, anywhere near like Slick Rick. Slick Rick tells a story, and he talks about different characters within the story, but he actually does the voice of each character. He's talking about, you know, Mona Lisa. You know, he went to the pizza shop and met a girl named Mona Lisa. He will act out the voice of that person, and he does it in so many of his rhymes. So his stories are already dope. His stories are vivid. His stories are comical. His stories are sometimes X-rated, but always entertaining. But vocally, they're genius, and it takes a lot of talent to do what he does. And I will go as far as declaring that Slick Rick probably is the most versatile MC I've ever heard as far as the usage of his voice. Again, he has the advantage of having the British accent. He already, you know, has that in place. But then when he tells his stories, the way he incorporates the characters in. Now, I started noticing on his debut album, his debut solo album, The Great Adventures of Slick Rick, on songs like Kit and Mona Lisa, the way that he does it, and again, it's genius, he will have at least two vocal tracks open, and he'll do all of his characters on one track, and he leaves a blank space. Then he comes back in and fills the replies back in for the other character. Now, I know that's not necessarily easy to comprehend if you're not a person that goes in the studio and does that kind of thing. But the way I can tell that he does that is because the vocals will overlap sometimes. If you listen to him sometimes, you'll hear the end of a sentence. You'll hear him come in on top of his own voice. And of course, the only way you can do that is by multi-tracking. So he'll lay down all his parts as, you know, as himself, as Slick Rick or whatever. And if he wants to say that he just, you know, met Mona Lisa, he'll leave those parts open. Then he'll come back in and actually do that voice. So he has a different vocal inflection for each character. And it's pretty damn brilliant. And the multi-tracking thing is something that a lot of people do. For myself, as one who every once in a while, I'll have a lapse into my childhood asthma. As an MC myself, for breath control sometimes, I won't do a whole verse. I won't sit up there and do a whole, you know, however many bars comprise my verse. I will do pieces and then go back in and record myself back over on another track. That way I don't have to go all the way through and do a whole verse. And it helps with breath control because, again, every once in a while I have a little lapse from my childhood asthma. So a lot of MCs use that for whatever reason. Another reason we use it is you can write a rhyme sometimes and it can fit perfectly if you're not writing it to the beat that you want to say it to. But when you go to actually write it and insert it into a beat, sometimes it doesn't fit. So the only way to do it is to do half of it or pieces of it on one track and then come back and fill it in. And you'll hear it with certain MCs, and you definitely hear it with any of my work, much of my work, you'll hear my voice overlap on the last sentence or last words of the previous sentence. And that's because you're doing a multi-tracking thing. So Slick Rick's doing it because it's almost like theater what he's doing. You know, when he tells a story, he's not saying, oh yeah, the girl said this, and doing it in his Slick Rick voice. When he said the girl said this, he's mimicking a female. And you got to really go back and listen to his songs to appreciate it, because the stories are so dope sometimes we're not really catching the vocal dynamic of what he's doing. And as I get into the music, I'll revisit that with some very specific instances of how he comes off with that. And the very last thing I'll say before we get into it, again, his storytelling abilities, no question. Everybody knows that he's the world's greatest storyteller. That's his title. But subject matter, I would say, as far as subject matter, he's also a top-tier MC as far as that category. I can't think of many MCs who will say a rhyme about how dope they are on the mic, and he has plenty of those, but will also go off into so many other things. I mean, he has songs about so many different subjects. You know, it's a boy, you know, when his son was born, he made a whole song about that. Then he'll do a message song like Hey Young World. And then on his second album, The Ruler's Back, one of my favorites of his, he did a song called Moses, where he goes and tells the whole biblical Moses story in his own style and voice. I can't think of many MCs as versatile and who are willing to come out of their shell and do so many different things, subject matter wise, as Slick Rick. And I need to hear more music from Slick Rick. I know he still tours a lot, and you know he's out there doing that, and he links up with Dougie Fresh, and they do their thing. But I would really like to hear some new music from Slick Rick. But let's get into it. Slick Rick came across my radar probably at the same time that he came across 99% of our radars on a 12-inch in 1985 called Lottie Dottie. in the show. Of course, the show was the A side, Lottie Dottie was the B side with the great Dougie Fresh. Now, I was already very familiar with Dougie Fresh, you know, and the human beatbox that he was doing. You know, the Fat Boys, you know, had their human beatbox debut sometime around the same time. There's always little subtle jabs between Dougie and the Fat Boys, really more from Dougie. You know, he had his song, the original human beatbox, which is on Bobby Robinson's Enjoy Records. And incredible song. May have been the first time I heard beatbox, and I'm pretty sure it was. Sometime probably 84 or so, that record probably came out. It was called the original human beatbox. And then, you know, he would take jabs at Buffy, rest in peace, from the Fat Boys, the human beatbox. And even on his show, when he said, I'm known for the, and then he did his little, not for the, you know, imitating Buffy. So he always kind of took digs at him. And now that I think about it, I want to say that Enjoy record in 84 was called Just Having Fun. And in parentheses, it was Do the Beatbox. It was Get Fresh, Doug, and Do the Beatbox. And then the Entertainment record later that year was called The Original Human Beatbox. So that's I mixed that up. But Dougie was also on Beat Street, and that was probably around 84 or so, where he made his debut on the soundtrack and on the movie with the Treacherous Three on Christmas Rap. So I was very, very familiar with Dougie Fresh. In 85, when I was in the record store and I saw this record on Reality Records called A Show, and the other side was Lottie Dottie, and I had never heard the song before. It probably just dropped that day when I was at the store. And I bought it just, you know, back then we bought records on the strength of who was produced by, what label it was on, the title of the record. I used to always read the credits to see who produced it. Even where it was mastered. If it was said it was mastered by Herb Powers at Frankfort Wayne, I would buy it based on that. Or if it had a scratch version, it had scratching, you know. Because back then, that's all you had, you know. Radio wasn't really playing hip-hop in the daytime. It was no hip-hop videos, like, talking about it, you know. It was just still a very underground thing, so you bought records based on those things, the label it was on, the title, and the names you saw in the credits. So I saw Dougie Fresh, and I saw Reality Records, and, you know, I already knew about Reality Records and, you know, some artists that had already been on Reality, and some of the names that I saw on there. I said, okay, this has got to be a good record, and this is Dougie Fresh. So I took the record home, and I was blown away by the music. I was blown away by the show, which, by the way, was produced by Teddy Riley and Bernard Bell, who's Regina Bell's brother. Definitely blown away by the music, blown away by the beatboxing on Lottie Dottie. But the cat rhyming, his voice, I couldn't stand the voice. That's another record you can add to the list of records that will become huge, monumental, records that shifted the paradigm of the whole game that I didn't like at first. I gave the record away within hours of getting it. I would always record music, put it on the boombox, go outside with it. And I recorded that, went outside with it. Didn't really blast it because I wasn't feeling it. And somebody asked, well, you know, if you don't want it, can I have it? I gave the record away, and I never gave records away. But I did not like the show in Lottie Dottie upon first hearing. I just couldn't get used to Slick Rick's voice. You know, you always had, as I say in so many of the lessons from this time, the dominant voices were, you know, those real strong voices, those real strong masculine voices, you know, the Melly Mel voice, the LL voice, the Run voice. Everybody was doing the growl at that point. You know, Treacherous 3 had just done Gotta Rock in 85, and, you know, Mo D had that line where he said you try to use big words so you can seem smarter, deepen your voices so you can rock harder. You know, it's the deep voice thing. And here comes Slick Rick. Not only did he not have a deep voice, he had a British accent, and he sounded effeminate to me on a lot of the part, because he was trying to be. I mean, you know, he was trying to sound, you know, imitating a chick on one part and doing a lot of singing, and it was a bit too much for me. I was not up on that. But that record in 85 became such a smash. I can remember when that record came out in the summer, when school started, everybody in the hallways, whether they, not even they weren't MCs or human beatbox cats, but everybody was beatboxing and singing Lottie Dottie in that time of 85. I can distinctly remember that song, Radio. I Can't Live Without My Radio by LL, and Morris Day had the Oak Tree out. And those were the three songs that everybody went nuts over that summer, going into the rest of 85 with those three songs. And it grew on me after a while. And I'm like, you know what, this ain't bad. And it wasn't a peer pressure thing of everybody else liked it, so I liked it. It's one of them things where, you know, your first listen, sometimes things have to grow on you. And the song grew on me, and I really, really started to appreciate what it took, you know, to put that vocal performance in. And of course, on the show in Lottie Dottie, you know, he out of the gate, Rick was telling stories, but he hadn't done the vocal thing yet, as far as really, really getting into the character, not yet. He was doing the singing already. And at this point, I like to talk about that, the singing. You know, MCs trying to sing, you know, has always been a thing. You know, you got your guys like Raheem from the Furious Five who really can sing. They really are like legitimate singers. They, you know, they got R&B songs where they've sang, and they also respected MCs. You got that kind of cat. You got a Biz Market that's just trying to be funny. You're not taking them serious. It's just for the humor of it. Then you got, you know, like even, you know, Jay-Z will do his little sing-songy thing. And at times that can get a little abrasive on the ears, you know, MCs trying to do that. You know, most of the time they're being damn near humorous when they do it, but it works a lot of times on songs, but sometimes it doesn't work. With Slick Rick, he's such a rhythmic and melodic cat that when he sings, he can actually hold a note. And when he does it, it to me, it's not a thing where it's abrasive to the ear. And it goes really well with his rhyme. It always is relevant to the rhyme and the story he's telling. So it doesn't come off as corny. So you saw that out of the gate with the debut. I'm not going to spend a lot of time on the show and Lottie Dottie because, you know, everybody knows it. But that was the seed that was planted that turned into this thing, you know, called Slick Rick, you know, the world's greatest storyteller.
Slick Rick! Well, here's a little something that needs to be heard. Doug, I was going downtown. Perfect. Word. Sure. All alone. No one to be with. Stepped on the deep end at 205th. I saw a pretty girl. So I sat beside her. Then she went real like she was Tony the Tiger. I said, hold on, there's been a mistake. Honey, my name's Slick Rick, not Frosty Flakes.
Oh, golly, why?
Cause she was raised in hell. She said, oh, my name is Maggie, but call me Michelle. Michelle, my belle, Sunday monkey, get in on some. Slick Rick and I'm rock the house, you know what I'm saying? And when I'm on the mic, there won't be no delaying. Bust a move, we show and prove. Hey, yo, Doug, do that record jam on the groove.
Repeat this, la-di-da-di, we like the party. We don't cause trouble, we don't bother nobody. We're just some men that's on the mic. And when we rock up on the mic, we rock the mic.
Right?
For all of y'all, keeping y'all in health. Just to see you smile and enjoy yourself. Cause it's cool when you cause a cozy condition, and that we create. Cause that's our mission, so listen to what we say. Because this type of shit, it happens every day. I woke up around 10 o'clock in the morning. I gave myself a stretcher, a morning yawning. Went to the bathroom to wash up. Had some soap on my face and my hand upon a cup. I said, mirror, mirror on the wall. Who is the top choice of them all? There was a, this is a girl plays hard to get. So I said, what's wrong? Cause she looked upset. She said, it's all because of you. I'm feeling sad and blue. You went away and now my life is filled with rainy days. And I love you so. How much you'll never know. Cause you took your love away from me.
So indeed, that was a monumental 12-inch. Spawned a whole lot of copycats. A lot of cats tried to do those kind of records, having somebody beatbox where they did that kind of voice. You know, years later, Snoop Dogg will remake that particular song, Lottie Dottie, and just became the template for that particular time period. Everybody wanted to try to tell stories and like I said, get that kind of cadence and voice like Slick Rick had. And then the Get Fresh crew disbanded and everybody went their separate ways, and Slick Rick had his own solo thing. And I believe the first solo thing I heard from him was Treat Her Like a Prostitute, which was, of course, humorous. And a lot of times, as he could get raunchy, you saw on the beginnings of that, on Lottie Dottie, you saw him getting a little raunchy there on a story at the end. A little early profanity, you know, in the rap thing. And, he's a little profane on Treat Her Like a Prostitute as well. And, of course, the smash hit from The Great Adventures of Slick Rick was definitely Children's Story. You know, that's the one that Montel Jordan went on to, you know, redo, and that's on all kind of TV commercials, and it's just a, it's an anthem for the party. You know, it definitely is a party starter, but it definitely wasn't the best song on the album. A great song, great storytelling abilities on there. You know, Dave the Dope Fiend shooting dope that don't know the meaning of water nor soap. I mean, this fly is a fly song, but there were definitely other great songs on the LP.
Grinning my teeth. It's the last day of the week. Boy, what a relief. My muscles kinda ache, they felt rigid and stiff. So I looked around and I smoked this big fat split. Now I'm happy as can be, I'm in this my head spell. I put some visor in my eyes so that no one can tell. It's 12:55, almost time for the bell. Put the breakfast in the mouth so that the mouth don't smell. Now back on the job, I don't bother no one. I keep strictly to myself and all my work gets done. Now the job's finally over, it's time to have fun. And I'm hanging out with Jeff, there's a kid named John. Y'all were drunker than a skunk and happy as can be. We went to the Latin quarters and we got in free. Scooping all the girls like nothing with my truck jewelry. Cause I'm a fly brown brother and you can't school me. Boogie Down was performing, hey they ain't no joke. And a bunch of Brooklyn kids was looking all down my throat. Was it my big chains with the big plates on them? Then they rolled on me and told me to run them. This was the really not real, they're just a front for the girls. Then a whole bunch of furious fists caved my world. I was in pain and so was shame. I wish I had not came. Had to kindly pick up my face and then fly home on the train. Then I went to an open store, that's where I brought me a quart. Then I went to the park and I sat and I thought. I seen Danny Boy Bluey's with his girl named Sarah in one of his cars. I think this one's up Rivera. She calls out to me, but I really couldn't hear her. So I went just a little bit closer so I'd hear a little clearer. She said,
I need Veronica Place, that's right near Tilden.
I said, I know where that's at cause that's right next to my building. I gave them the information and they went on their way. I went home and there I slept till almost 3 the next day. Then someone knocked on my door, I opened up, no quit. It was Sarah with some magazines and a band-aid kit. She tried to use me and seduce me and at first I wasn't with it. Then we did it and we did it and we did it and we did it. She said it was great, she said she's glad we had done it. The elevator came and Danny Boy was on it. This was the moment I feared.
Now, you can see that he's doing the multi-tracking and getting into character on The Moment I Feared. But what I liked the most about The Moment I Feared was the cadence. You know, got me drunker than a skunk and happy as can be. We went to the lag quarters and we got in free. The cadence is something that wasn't being done on that level at the time. And when you combine the cadence with his vocals, the production, and just the uniqueness of the story he's telling, it was a hell of a combination. It worked very well. So that was definitely one of the standouts on the LP. Yeah, that cadence is something else. You know, she calls out to me, but I really couldn't hear. So I went just a little bit closer, so I hear a little clearer. That's flyness. You could tell he really had graduated from what he was doing on Lottie Dottie in the show. You know, the voice had matured, and he had mastered his flow and cadence, and just the dynamic of his voice. It was just so much better on this full-length album, and Moment I Feared was definitely a top-notch cut.
Lights, camera, action, you're on. Get it, Ricky D, what's wrong?
The crown's gone, so help me out, kid, cause this thief has to be caught. Radio the chief of police, get a report.
Chief of police said,
Welp, I'm sorry, Ricky D, cause I really can't help.
My drats, I think I'll take a long walk.
Kid, put your scan on all these rappers in New York. But Michael's calling me, Rick, I have to go. If I get a word, you'll definitely be the first to know.
Well, all that night, I felt really uptight.
Hello, Rick, it's Vance Wright. Pulling your clothes, I found them, they're downtown.
Word.
Someone's having a contest and they're using your crown.
What? You sure it's mine?
Yo, Rick, I know the shape of it, come on.
You know your scratches?
Yeah, plus I got a tape of it.
Get off my house quick, ride your motorcycle.
Bet.
Kid, Ricky, Rick, pick up, forget him, Michael.
Well, here came the DJ, truck to say the least.
Hey, yo, let me hear the tape.
It's a complete masterpiece.
Yeah, but yes, it kinda is, but this we're bound to overtake. I heard a, that's Kid, so let's break. Here go my rap kit, analyzer hit. So Kid, what's the scoop?
Slick Rick, this one is it.
Tummy was growling while I was chilling in my seat. We stopped by McDonald's, so I guess I'm Nate. Skipped the line and the crowd started to break.
Hey, yeah, let me get a Big Mac and a strawberry shake.
Someone snatched me by my neck, I thought I must be dead.
Get off.
Injected me with something, threw a bag over
Ow.
My head. I felt real weak, worried, I couldn't even stand. I fell, next thing I was being thrust inside a van. Unconscious, who could be this shady? When I awoke, I was in a room with this lady.
So you're the boss, Rick Rick, with all the clout?
Uh-huh, now why am I tied up and what's this all about? And then she left the room, this was my one chance for hope. I used my watch lighter to burn away the rope. Then I was free, and no one was alerted. I made a flying leap through the window and it hurted.
someone through a knife. Who could be this trite? So I ran cause I was petrol for my life. Stranded in Rye, I saw a phone not far. I radioed into my superdelic car. Yo, what's with the contest? Am I still in it to win it? Yes, I'm in Manhattan and I'll be there in a minute. And oh, by the way, I've re-listened to your hit. Hey Rick, what's the scoop? Oh man, this one is lit.
Again, just as far as being creative, one of the more creative or most creative MCs still to this day, you know, for those that remember, Kit was the car on Knight Rider. And what Slick Rick was actually doing on that song was, you know, playing a position of Knight Rider or Knight Rider and Kit's the car. And so he makes a story out of that. I mean, just not a lot of MCs that's going to go to those lengths to put themselves in a character like that and then do the voices and everything. And you can see all that developing. You know, the voices and the multi-track, and, you know, still hasn't really, really mastered it yet. But, you know, he's getting there on that. And again, just very creative and just a really fly story.
Excuse me, I'm trying to earn in me a buck or two. A silent rapper come in, and who the fuck are you? Around this part of town with diamonds and your girl in fur. I'm trying to enter in this rap contest you're having, sir. You're kind of late, flat tire, well, let's do a cut. Well, all right, pay me now, and you'll be after her. I hope I don't mess up or run out of breath or even Rick. Don't worry, hon, you hit him harder than a fucking brick. Well, what do you think, Vance? Please, no one can serve us. Wish me luck, dear, I'm scared and I'm nervous. So who stands, who falls, who crowds the halls? This one, the DJ falls. Lick the balls. Lick the balls. Now every time I write dope raps, they come picking it. Now you know the title of this, so start licking it. Rinse kicking it, hey bitch, there is a brick in it. So when y'all think you're prepared, I keep sticking it. Now here they come with the fight, take it light. Now who the one you're trying to be like with all your might? And anyone attempting to remove me out the race, let's give me space before I be right in they fucking face. Or is that thought, go play that role around your local hoods. Don't worry about a thing cause Ricky Rick is bringing home the goods. Who stands, who falls, who crowds the halls? This one the DJ calls. Lick the balls.
Well, it was one of those days,
not much to do.
I was chilling downtown
with my old school crew.
I went into a store
to buy a slice of pizza.
I bumped into a girl.
Her name was Mona. What?
Mona Lisa.
What?
Mona Lisa. So many. You know what I'm saying? So I said,
excuse me there.
My gosh, you look nice.
Put away your money.
I'll buy that slice.
She said, thanks. I'd rather a slice of you. I'm just kidding, but that's awfully nice of you.
The compliment showed she had a mind in her. And when I smiled, I almost blinded her.
She said, great Scott, are you a thief? Seems like you have a mouthful of gold teeth.
Ha ha ha, I had to find that funny. So I said, no child, I work hard for the money. And calling me a thief, please, don't even try
right?
it. Said, I need to slice a pizza and be quiet. She almost got cut short.
You know, scissor.
She tried to disrespect who?
The Grand Wizard.
Me?
What's your name, sir?
MC Ricky D, but not to be so harsh, I said to Mona Lee.
Hey. Oh, I'm sorry, and I know that's low class.
Please sit, yeah. Tell me a little about your past.
She said, well, I got courage, and I don't like courage. Uh-huh. I've never been to college, but I've got crazy knowledge. Uh-huh. Over 18, and my eyes are green.
Uh-huh.
I wear more gold than that man on 18.
Uh-huh.
Trim, slim, and I'm also light skin. Best believe Mona's a virgin.
A virgin?
Honey needed a slap.
She tried to tell me she's a virgin.
With a yay white gap.
I said, it don't matter, see, I'm not picky.
What?
Let me spell my name out for you, it's
uh-huh.
Ricky.
Yeah.
Ravishing,
impressive,
courageous, or careless.
Okay.
For the Kangos, which I've got, that I wear every day.
And why?
Why not?
The fight's not right that I recite tonight.
Quite polite like Walter Cronkite.
Well, just about then, Trevor, my friend, came in. He said,
hey, Rick, don't you know playing with these snakes is a sin?
He grabbed me by my shirt and pulled me right out the store, he said.
I don't want to see you playing with these lowlights no more. Now come along, we have a party to attend with some real mature women and some more of our friends.
He held down a cab and he waited for a minute, and as the cab came, he thrusted me in it. And as we were leaving,
ain't
telling how long, I could hear a melody as Mona sang a song.
If you see me walking down the street, and I start to crash, honey, walk on by, walk on by, foolish pride, that's all that I have left, so let me hide the pain and the hurt that you gave me when you said goodbye, walk on by.
So yeah, that's definitely my favorite on The Great Adventures of Slick Rick. Again, his debut album, Mona Lisa. And on that one, you can tell more so than any of his others on this album that he's using the multi-tracking technique that I was talking about, where he lays certain characters and certain vocal inflections he lays on one track. Then he comes back in and fills the blanks. So like when the song starts and he says, "It was one of those days, not much to do. I was chilling downtown with my old school crew." It's very melodic. You know, he's flowing like on the musical scale almost. It's very musical the way he's talking when he's telling the story. And like I said, he's putting himself on different tracks, and you can tell as he's speaking as the different voices will overlap. And it's a brilliant technique. It's an entertaining technique, and probably the most innovative and unique, definitely for MCs at that time. And I haven't heard many people do things on that level since, you know, creativity-wise. You know, I think he's one of the more creative MCs to ever touch the mic, you know. And as I'm doing this particular lesson and delving deeper into some of the songs of his that I didn't listen to as much back in the days, it kind of verifies and solidifies that he's one of the more creative cats on the mic.
Indian town in what spots is on? What? A nice looking Indian and honey look fly. He had to talk because he just couldn't hack it. She wore some moccasins and plus a tough leather jacket. He tried it over and invented a line. He said, "Excuse me, do you happen to have the time?" All was on his mind was sex, sex, sex. So she said,
"Why don't you ask? You got your own time, Max."
To poor old Dave, that line was cold-blooded. It seemed like her ego was way overflooded. She started to laugh, and then she started to say,
"I'm sorry, sometimes I do get carried away. I didn't mean to, like, ill-treat you. My name is Running Rabbit, and I'm glad to meet you."
He said, "I'm Dave with Crazy Cloud." She said,
"Oh, you're the one the girls be talking about. Yeah, you must be, because you look like a winner. Come to my house, we'll discuss it over dinner."
Davey Crockett.
Shows his inquiring noses, going into a story about a kid named Moses. Once a prophet was to be born, so for anything else fervid, Pharaoh orders every firstborn son murdered. One got away, a girl with prophet bound with her, gently put him in a basket, went floating down the river. Then ends up by a Pharaoh relative, a honey peeped in, couldn't breed herself and was determined to keep it. "Don't say a word," she told a slave, "who was a real witch? Snitch, it'll definitely be the last day you breathe, bitch." Wild kids slaughtered, cause they was fun of them, soldiers telling the king that they murdered every one of them. "Thanks," said Pharaoh, dies with a fent tip. Sister showing the baby, saying the river God sent him. To a brother who arose and said, "Whoa, sis, cures, I suppose, is the upward nose about Moses." As time passed, it proved he wasn't the type to beg or borrow. Grew to conquer lands like ain't no tomorrow. Made the sun king jealous cause he couldn't do what Mo did. "Pops, I'm not too happy the way y'all jocking this Mo. Son, this rash behavior ruins every feast of bash. And why complain? And where's the temple I asked you to build your piece of trash? To your switch, Mo, you build it and you find a supreme hero. Built it, anything else you need, Pharaoh? King astonished, here's my crown." One said, "How can he? But since not taking any chances, threw the hooker off the balcony. But we'll still got the king. Ain't cold curse blessed. Stripped him of his honors and dumped him in the desert. But Mo returned for the people. His chest if out saw. King said, "You want war? Make brick without straw." That's the son not being king, the shorty no good roses. Unhappy, I suppose, is the upward nose about Moses.
Yeah, to me that's just fly. I mean, to take a biblical story and then, you know, update it with the slang of, you know, whatever year that was, probably 91 or so. And make a fly song out of it. It's just creative. Again, he's one of the more creative cats. And that's not the kind of song that was going to get a lot of airplay. In fact, that album didn't get a lot of airplay. Didn't get much critical success. But it's one that, when it came out, I definitely liked it. I think the first single was I Shouldn't Have Done It, which I wasn't in love with. But once I got the album, was one I kept in rotation. It didn't really have any singles that really, you know, broke through, like smash hits or anything. But it's definitely a solid album, and I think it's aged well. You know, the more I listen to it, that's one that I pick out and listen to. You know, I've listened to throughout the years, and it's aged very well as far as I'm concerned.
Hey. look tired, desire me. There was a beauty I admired. Out by the 41, broke, no joke. Can have a tug, fine hooker, so smile and spoke. Gave the girl my number, though I still felt rejected. Hectic, caught me more than I expected. Months passed by, even lived together and all. Dream come true until suddenly a call. Oh brother, why do I discover my honey Tamika, yeah, calling me another. Broke out it again, it offend and I pretend. Mistakes of a woman in love with a man. Try to block it out my mind, here it was again. Other men confronted later and she said he was a friend. Didn't believe her, she packed. Brave her, strange behavior, so silly, me forgave her. Late again Thursday, alone Rick sat. Left flat, look in the mirror and I wonder where she at. Gave the girl my heart and soul, it's after 10. And again, couldn't manage if she slept with other men. Out with my jewelry, so you know she looked truck. Struck 3 o'clock, here she come, fishy like a fuck. Come here, let me smell you, I wanted to say to hell you. Hi honey, sorry I'm late, but let me tell you. It's a fast chat, need the phone so open. Could you go to the store and get some soda, cause they're open. Again, it offend and I pretend. Mistakes of a woman in love with other men.
He said, she's out with my jewelry, so you know she looked truck. 3 o'clock, here she come, fishy like a fuck. I thought that was funny. And that was one of my favorites from the album. I really like Mistakes of a Woman in Love with Other Men. Kind of vulnerable there, you know, for MC at that time to, you know, make a song about, you know, getting cheated on like that, getting played out like that. He also said, could you go to the store and get some soda because they're open? Just the way he, and if you listen, he made his voice very somber for that. You know, not a lot of cats do that. Average MC has the same vocal tone, same inflection, same cadence for every song. But he will adjust his mood for the subject matter of the song, as you should. You're supposed to. But a lot of MCs don't do that. A lot of cats, you know, what you get is what you always get. But with him, you know, he's talking about a somber subject, and he's got a very somber tone on the song. And again, that's a cat who's mastered his craft.
It's me at last, the Rickster. Death Jazzer, I'll be at most agree. It's kind of amazing folks are born from where we pee at. Though I definitely fiend it. Baby, no way, chills, clever, mean it. Been
got to be careful.
Commercial,
told.
Ever seen it? Born a few, I rope. Someone asked about cheating, do I know? Not a dope, love the mother, also loves me too, I hope. So I dig her a lot and all those shorty honey breaking.
Nigga,
how you figure?
Being a big rap money making nigga.
As a
bitch about the time we pick for cotton, so it ain't forgotten. Hope I don't spoil the nigga rotten.
Also,
don't discriminate white.
It be quite bright,
shorty
might.
If naughty like S Heavenly Father, help me raise my shorty right. So when I come on with the coil,
I say yo shorty, run to boil.
Seen as I'm loyal and living on soil, it's best when has someone to spoil.
So any toy he wants, he gets.
Yo, kids ain't worth it, mix of joy. Say they destroy your
joy. Throw me in the mobs in the middle of fits of joy, and it's a boy.
Around Wall Street with the ties on. Finest girl above, I think he ever set eyes. A nice day, weather sunny, as he made a run for honey with a warm personality.
While it's on the run,
how the tongue that right there seemed kind of fun to pair. Wondering there as he telling me he could get the underwear. Meanwhile, still jocking her like a real sucker. Since the witch was so fine, she could have AIDS.
I still not.
Heart beating for her since her brother didn't figure me. And as I asked her if she's single,
yeah, I caught my nigga cheat.
Nice to meet you, leaves. She had dope combined features. Watched her walk away and observing the fine creature. Next day again, one of her underbites of brine with us. Ran into so much that her and her friends decided to hang with us. Then pair moved on fine.
Can I take you out to movies, why line the whole nine?
She condoned, good
riddance, nigga slid the song.
Didn't want the kid to bone her, though I knew I didn't own her. And I could've made a move, a little willpower does all. Although she told him that she liked him as a friend and that was all. And since hang with us, shorty told her, cool, you freaked out a week. Of my birthday, bought me a pair of Gucci sneakers. Did she like me, resting her thought, was it sign? Guess I'll wear tomorrow. When she saw me, definitely dissing kinda special.
Since for this dish, none of it,
but everybody wanna play. How long is money gonna waste? I asked the honey on a date. And she accepts, so thought it wasn't much a plan. Windows of the world, even had the nerve to touch her hand. Thought I looking at bashful. So I suppose I was so shy and then a hand pulls closer. Thought clever hands, so was she straight? Never been so excited and convinced. Kissed in heaven ever since. Holding her hand too, chilling. Future plan to build. Couldn't believe my dream fulfilled. All in a grill began to ill by saying,
lady, if you will,
if you will,
say you're the one that sent for me to thrill. Someone that I can hold close in my arms with all of the charms of you. It's all of the charms of you.
Of you.
again, you know, to get vulnerable like that on It's a Boy, you know, a lot of MCs just wasn't on that level to dedicate a whole song to their newborn. And then the one just now, Venus, I put that on just to showcase again the flow, but the fact that he could hold a note when he sang, it sounded like with some purpose with it. You know, he's actually trying to sing a song, not just singing just to be doing something. You know, there's some purpose that is directly tied into the song and what the song is, and it feels right when he does it and it sounds good. So again, you know, his whole timeline with his legal troubles and everything, it definitely had a detrimental effect on his music. You know, the selections I just played were from his second album, The Ruler's Back, and then he had an album called Behind Bars. And it was, I guess, life imitating art or art imitating life. I guess depends on which way you want to look at it. But I mean, he was actually behind bars, and you know, he was talking about what he was living. And by that time, the West Coast was dominant. You know, you had Warren G and Snoop and the whole Death Row thing. And actually, the ironically and surprisingly for me, the Warren G remix was the joint for Behind Bars. Not that I'm taking anything from Warren G, he just didn't come with the expected G-funk type of remix. He came with a very jazzy, at the time, a boom bap East Coast flavor mix.
In the slammer kid,
but I'm innocent.
Lord played with, he wasn't having any pity.
Now in Razor Blade City,
cries opposed the situation, seen mad eyes opposed, tries arose.
Hey yo, money, what size are those?
Neither for me, two another sprang up.
To gang up
on this kid, house in the foam, like he didn't know how to hang up.
Would be hard though, up to a minute or so, and then yells, time on.
And when you get your commissary by this and that, or else I'm going to.
You're not asking, won't stay off.
Extort, figure I safe, way off.
Feel the death,
you ain't protecting me.
Forgot today's my day off.
Hold my head and drift, assume awaiting's nuts and cars.
Instead of sitting here accumulating cuts and scars. Behind bars.
This type of shit, it happens every day.
Six up, punk locked up to get beat down. Break down to his knees, broke down.
This type of shit, it happens every day.
Riots, melee, and disturbances of the peace.
Not trying to claim things I haven't earned, honest man. Slick Rick and Outkast is on this jam. But kid Diamond on a 2-2 grand, trying to help raise our youth to man. See if the ruler Rick, his face to slam, help clean up this land. The reputation of this man, with hole and with stand.
Outcast and Slick, the answer is in it. Hun, you need to get your ass on the dance floor this minute. We bruise duck, knock you out, shoe sock. Show your ass move, you forgot what mad smooth snucks.
La-di-da-di.
We like to party, don't make me get money and platinumize my body. With bright stuff known to earn a dice, love blind folks, but like somebody turn the lights off. Immense strength popping out of muffin, make famous artists that's dead hop out of coffin. At the real estate behaving type choosy, want a palace, make the shit beige and light blue, please. Got the kid like watch your manners, since I came out of jail, it's like the planet gone bananas. Like the strength a battle fella had, lady looking at me all stink, I had to tell her that.
Not trying to claim things I haven't earned, honest man. Slick Rick and Outkast is on this jam. What kid Diamond on a 2-2 grand, trying to help raise our youth to man. See if the ruler Rick, his face to slam, help clean up this land.
I always did love that song. That was Street Talking from his sort of a comeback album of sorts. You know, he had just gotten out of prison, and that album was called The Art of Storytelling. And that was Street Talking with the big boy from Outkast. Always did love what Rick did on the hook with that. You know, just, again, his vocals, what he could do with his voice. Really a unique MC. I never really liked the way Big Boy fit on that track. I didn't think they should have been together on that track. I think that should have been a track where Slick Rick rocked it alone. You know, I thought he should have held that one down by itself. It was kind of an awkward pairing, but I understood, you know, what they were trying to do, because Outkast was so huge at the time, but never did like the pairing of them together on that song. But so definitely, like I said, if it wasn't for Slick Rick's personal, you know, life issues and legal issues, you know, and combined with the production or lack of better production, I think he could have went a lot further and stayed a lot more relevant for a lot longer than he did. But again, he never He never did fall lyrically, and he never fell, again, stylistically, vocally. Just one of the more well-rounded cats out there as far as subject matter. On that Art of Storytelling album, he actually had a song about anal sex on there, a whole song where he goes in-depth about it. And, you know, who does that, you know? And comes and makes it work, you know? You know, it's not going to be a hit or a radio single or anything, but I mean, you know, to go there, you know, he's a creative cat. And again, I just wanted to say that beyond storytelling, you know, of course he's a great storyteller, one of the best, but I think equally, you know, if maybe more important to me, what he does vocally, just like a unique voice and unique cadence. If you even the songs that didn't have the best production behind them, if you listen to how he approaches his rhyme structure on a lot of the songs and what he does with his voice, is just really incredible. You know, Slick Rick is an MC's MC. You know, those who write rhymes and can appreciate poetic value really, really can see the greatness of Slick Rick a lot more than a lot of people who don't. And this is Jayquan, Foundation Lesson number 22, The Vocal Genius of Slick Rick the Ruler. Hopefully you found it enlightening, intriguing, entertaining, and all that good stuff. You can hit me online, check the website, thefoundation.com, thafoundation.com. You go to the mobile site. At the top of that page, there's a button that says visit mobile site. If you visit the mobile site, and I think if you click on more options, there's a bunch of stories, interviews, video interviews, written text interviews, interviews with R&B, funk artists, you know, 90-some percent interviews with old-school MCs, but some of everything there. And all social media, you can hit me at Jayquan VA. Peace.